Tonight in Ankara, peace protesters and riot police played a sinister game of follow my leader. Such demonstrations are illegal. These flower-carrying pacifists risk jail if they express any anti-war sentiments. So this wasn't a protest, it was a silent walk in the park. And to start with, the authorities remain content to listen out for dangerous talk.
Bir dakika arkadaşlar, bir dakika. Almak zorunda kalırım seni.
Peki, ben gidiyorum.
Tamam, hadi bakalım.
Inevitably, their patience failed and the arrests began.
Police are quick to stifle any opposition to the war. The country, it's argued, must appear united. And yet the Turkish government is showing two quite contradictory faces, one to its own people, the other to the West. To the Europeans and the Americans, they portray themselves as willing allies in the war. To the local population, they portray themselves as resolutely neutral. However that contradiction resolves itself will have profound implications for the future of Turkey.
Turkey's President Özal believes Saddam may have provided him with a timely opportunity to win valuable brownie points with the West. Modeling himself on Kemal Atatürk, the architect of modern Turkey, he yearns for acceptance as a genuinely European nation. But all his recent overtures have been rebuffed. EC membership's been rejected, and Turkey's importance as a NATO member has diminished since the end of the Cold War. Last week on television, Mr. Özal told his people that if he'd had his way, Turkish troops would have been sent to the Gulf. As it is, he said, their support for the Allies may still ensure Turkey becomes a more powerful nation. But the leader of the main opposition party is worried. Far from being a new Atatürk, he says Özal looks dangerously like a new Enver Pasha. He was the last Sultan's prime minister who secretly took Turkey into the First World War on the German side and so lost them the Ottoman Empire.
It is a policy which may give Mr. Özal some political advantage in the short run. He may appear as one of the victorious leaders at the end of this war, because clearly the Allies will win this war. And Mr. Özal will appear as one of the victorious Allies. But it will not help us restore, help us establish good relations with the Arab world after the end of the war.
But with the diplomatic sleight of hand that has characterized politics here for 70 years, Turkey is playing it both ways. Last week, when Baghdad threatened Ankara over the use of US bases, the Iraqi ambassador was summoned to the foreign ministry, not for a dressing down, but to be told that the two countries are still friends, and it was all a terrible misunderstanding.
We have expressed our feelings and understanding about the Gulf crisis, and Mr. Ambassador understands Turkish behavior, and as far as himself is concerned, we do not have any problems.
Doesn't it put Turkey in a difficult position, though, when US bombers are flying from Turkish soil into Iraq?
Turkish position is well known by everybody. If it is difficult, it is difficult.
Turkey's foreign policy seems based on the motto of Atatürk himself, peace at home, peace in the world. Simply, they work hard to remain friends with all their neighbors. Turks are profoundly aware of their geographical vulnerability. To the north, the old communist bloc. To the east, Persians. West, Europeans. South, Arabs. It is a Muslim country, but there's very little evidence of support for Saddam. There's also very little evidence of support for war.
90% of the people doesn't want that Turkey goes into the war. But on the other hand, nearly 52%, more than half of the people, once that Saddam goes, they think that Saddam is a very dangerous man, and the international community must do something for him, and he must leave the power in Iraq. So this is a very confused feeling. So I think Mr. Özal is playing in that confusion in the feelings of people.
If Mr. Özal is playing on people's confusion, he's doing it with the help of censorship so ham-fisted, opposition MPs were moved to invade the state television station. The Director General's private secretary ended up on the floor as normally respectable politicians demanded to see his boss. Why, they asked, were CNN reports on the US base at Incirlik replaced by pictures of mountains and scenery? Why was film of anti-war protests in which one man was killed never shown on the news? And why, they demanded, does President Özal appear so often?
He has no really excuse for appearing on television so much, because our president does not enjoy the constitutional prerogatives that either Mr. Bush or Mr. Mitterrand, for instance, enjoys. We don't have a presidential system, we have a parliamentary system. But no, you see Mr. Özal every night.
By contrast, Mr. İnönü was due to have addressed a public meeting in this Ankara cinema today. But late last night, security police told organizers it had been postponed for 2 months.
Why are the Turkish government apparently preventing public debate?
Well, I don't wish to comment on that any further, but I would like to say that this is a period in which we need calm, unity, and peace to the extent possible within our frontiers.
Despite, or maybe because of the restrictions, anti-war protest has taken an increasingly violent form over the past few days. There's been a wave of small bomb explosions at Western, Arab and Turkish targets. And after Friday prayers last week, Muslims in Istanbul burned the Stars and Stripes as police opened fire with tear gas. By Turkish standards, the unrest is small scale, but the government knows it may escalate if there's any suggestion that Turkey's becoming more involved in the war. Only today, a senior government official confirmed to Newsnight that the Turkish troops now stationed on the Iraqi border are there, partly to divert some of Saddam's troops from the south. The admission adds weight to speculation that Mr. Özal is already on the road to opening up a second front.
Do you think that Turkey will get embroiled in this war, that Turkish soldiers will fight Iraqi soldiers?
I don't want it, but I am not feeling any confidence in the way the government is handling the affair. So I am very much worried that when and if it becomes necessary, the Turkish troops should take an active part in the battle, the government may very well give that permission.
Turkey has no intention whatsoever, unless it is attacked by Iraq, to engage in any military operations by any element of its forces. I can say that categorically.
Even if the Americans came to you and said that it would help in the war in the south if you opened up a second front here?
We make our decisions ourselves.
Even if the Turkish government is determined not to enter the war, it's certainly determined to be in on the peace and the rewards that might follow. President Özal is already clearing his path, a precarious route that he believes will give Turkey greater influence and power without betraying the vision of his country's founder.